So I've been seeing some YouTube trends recently that I'm not too happy with. Let's Plays have been around since forever, and there's nothing wrong with that. It's when people make Let's Plays of narrative games or visual novels. That's what I have a problem with. There's also this trend of YouTubers making smear campaigns against other YouTubers, and it's creating this really toxic environment. I'm gonna get into all of this right after this intro. Go ahead and play the intro. Last week, Ryan Green, the developer of That Dragon Cancer, made a blog post basically saying that they haven't made any money off of the game sales despite how popular the game's been. The game has been particularly popular on the Let's Play scene here on YouTube, garnering millions of views, but Green hasn't seen a single dime from that. That Dragon Cancer is a narrative-driven game about Green's late 5-year-old son who fought with cancer. It's currently at a 78 on Metacritic, which is pretty respectable, but nobody's playing it. The story is enticing and touching, but people are getting that story from the Let's Plays. After seeing the Let's Play, why would somebody want to buy the game? The experience isn't going to be that different. The argument is that Let's Plays are transformative media that are covered under fair use. That means that the Let's Player is adding their own brand of humor or their own spin on the game, making the video their own. This is without a doubt the case in Mario Maker, CSGO, I don't know, Uncharted. Any game that's not just a narrative-driven game. Sure, a game like Uncharted has cutscenes, but if I watch all the cutscenes on YouTube, I'm missing out on 80% of the experience, which is playing the damn thing. That's where all the fun is, the gameplay. If a narrative game has multiple narrative paths, it could be argued that one Let's Play is that person's experience and you might have a different experience. That is a little bit more kosher. But doing a Let's Play of a narrative game with only one possible path is like doing commentary over a movie. Mystery Science Theater does this, but they actually have to track down the copyright owner and buy the license to use that movie. By making a Let's Play or even a live stream of a narrative game, you're giving your viewers the entire experience of watching that game, but you're only adding your own commentary over it. So you're giving them a little bit extra, but you're still giving them all that they need to experience that game. That does not give the viewer the same incentive to then go out and buy the game like it would with a game like Electronic Super Joy, which I watched a Let's Play for that, and then I went out and I bought the game because it looked awesome. And I've done that many times. Let's Plays are a good way to market your game, unless it's a narrative game, with nothing else to offer but a story. Proper etiquette for YouTubers and live streamers would be to avoid making content using these narrative games, especially if they're indie games. These creators deserve compensation for their work, and at this point, it's blatantly stealing. Now, another trend you might have heard about on YouTube are these reaction videos. These guys just straight up steal another person's YouTube video, shove it in the corner, watch it in almost complete silence, and then commentate on it at the end. After watching one of these videos, you have no incentive to then watch the video on the original creator's channel. These people are basically just stealing views. And even when you search for that first video, you might get the reaction video instead, especially if that YouTuber is even more popular. This whole stealing views thing sounds a lot like the Let's Play issue. Now, not all reaction videos are bad. H3H3 and Grade A Under A are some examples of really good reaction videos because they don't put all of their target's video in their video, and they make it transformative media. If you end up wanting to see the whole video, you have to click through to the other person's channel to watch the whole thing. But as much as I love these guys, they grew their channel by stirring up drama and controversy. They put other YouTubers on blast for making offensive or cringeworthy videos. I have to say that 90% of the time, when these people put somebody on blast, that person deserves it. Problem is, this is inspiring other YouTubers to do the same thing, and they're not very good at it at all. They aren't doing it all in good fun. They're just smearing around their hate, sometimes targeted towards people who don't deserve it at all. A good way to grow your channel is to make friends with other YouTubers and make videos with them. That way, you can put yourselves in front of each other's viewers. These new YouTube people are accomplishing the same thing, but by getting into fights with other YouTubers and getting them to make a reaction video. The more videos you make back and forth, the more attention the controversy gathers. I'm not a guy for drama. I don't give into that kind of bullshit. Sometimes the best thing to do is to just not give them what they want. And definitely do not go on drama alert. That's asking for a lot of trouble. Even if you're right, you have no idea what side this dude's on or what he's feeling that day. It's very easy to have a bias. It's very easy to create a bias out of nothing. It's super easy to take something that you say out of context and make people hate you for it. All right, I'm happy. I beat Vicky. The YouTube etiquette here is to not grow your channel off of the hate flung towards other YouTube channels. That's a surefire way to get you subscribers that are just as shitty as you are. It takes a lot of talent and care to make a tasteful reaction video. And definitely do not put another YouTuber on blast if they have less subscribers than you. That's using your power for evil. Believe it or not, PewDiePie recently did this in a very tasteful way. He made himself the butt of the joke. He could have easily just said, hey, I'm the number one subscribed to channel on YouTube, piss off. But he didn't. And that's why he's as popular as he is, because he's a nice guy and he knows what he's doing. So the YouTube etiquette lessons here are do not make Let's Plays or streams off of narrative-driven games, and do not slander other YouTube channels. If you really, really have to, they better f***ing deserve it. Anyway, what do you guys think about this whole YouTube controversy? All of it, all of the YouTube controversies. Leave it in the comments below. Add me on Twitter, all this other social media garbage. You, as the YouTube people, need to not watch Let's Plays on these narrative games. Especially if you're interested in it. If you're very interested in it, like let's say you're interested in Firewatch, don't watch a Let's Play on Firewatch. Or don't let that stop you from buying the game. And with the whole YouTube controversy thing, you know what? Sometimes they're very interesting. Sometimes you just get sucked into these YouTube controversies. I try to make a conscious effort not to watch drama alert stuff because that guy's just such a you know what? I can't. I'm gonna be nice. We're being nice here. Anyway, we have new videos every single Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Wednesday night at 9 p.m. is Wolf Den Live! Every single Wednesday. Live streams once a week, whenever the hell I feel like it. Follow me on Twitter for that. And if you're at all interested in Batman vs. Superman this weekend, we put a lot of Batman vs. Superman stuff up. We have a little reaction video. Go watch that. But out of all these things, the most important things that you can do is subscribe and share this video with a friend. We are almost at 10,000 subs. And that would be awesome. Thank you guys very much. Have a good week. The obvious thing to do here is just start off by dumping a bunch of money into equipment. Because the nicer the equipment is, the better streamer you'll be. No. Don't do that. That's stupid. Just use your PlayStation or Xbox camera because the content is what matters the most here.
So the route is... The route we're doing is J&L Game. We're gonna go up here to the Nintendo store, which is somewhere around here. I don't know why it's not coming up now. And we're gonna take the subway all the way down to 8-Bit and Up. Video Games New York, and then we're gonna eat some Korean food.